Hello. I'm doing another 30-minute recording for Grandmaster Analysis. And my opponent's playing a Sicilian. I lost last week. I had some good takeaways. I was not playing aggressive enough. So the Accelerated Dragon. Not a fan. I think I can play this. My repertoire against it is not the greatest, but I'm just gonna try this. Seems reasonable. Should I play a3 here to bring my bishop back? I suppose I can play d4 now. Let's just play aggressively. Get into some mainline. Like I said, I'm not really sure what's going on here, so. Can I just take? Maybe that's good because he can't take with the pawn. Because I win a pawn, I think. And, I know. He takes with that pawn. He gets another central pawn. Maybe I should just develop my bishop for now, but I'm just gonna play knight to f6. Maybe I can play f3 then. I honestly have no idea what's going on in this opening. Knight takes, d takes on c is fine, I think. B takes on c, however. B takes on c, and I'm not sure what's going on. He's ready to play d5 or something. Let's just play the bishop out. And if he plays a knight out, I'll just play f3. Could play the knight out here. Then if he brings the queen out, pin in a knight, then I can play f3 maybe. It's probably fine. It looks better than f3 in any case. So I don't think the putting queen on d2 works in these lines, but I'm not really sure. Queen on d2 might work here though. Although he takes, I take with a knight. He takes my queen, I take, and then the other knight is in trouble. Isn't it? I really don't know what happens after f3, but I'm just gonna do it anyway. This is the problem when you don't know the lines of an opening. This guy obviously plays this quite a lot. He's got me in his territory. But my position doesn't look bad. I mean, f3 looks ugly, but that bishop's there protecting, right? So. Okay, so if I put this bishop back, Bishop on b3. What's the deal? He can take, and I'll take, and I'm fine. Is he gonna try and win the bishop? Could also put my bishop on b5. Could also put my knight on b5. Don't think any sacrifice is working. That queen looks pretty uncomfortable there. But my bishop needs protecting. What can I play? Queen to. No, queen to e. I mean, it kind of works, queen to e2 as well. Problem is, after he takes, he's attacking my knight, and that's not good. Bishop b3. Knight to a5. Yeah, maybe knights d2 to b5. Trying for a3. Where is this queen going? Okay, so he takes my bishop, I play a3. It just looks scary for him. I guess he has queen, no, because my knight's gonna be on b5. I guess he can go to a5, but I can take and get another tempo. And I lose my bishop, but I'm just gonna play it, I think. What else am I gonna do? Queen to e2 doesn't look good. I could also play. No, b3 just weakens the dark squares too much. Okay, let's do this. Knight to a5. Then I can maybe play knight d2 to b5. I guess you can do that because you'll get that back. That's annoying. Did not consider that. Like, he's just winning a pawn, right? Nothing more. Well, I think I have to take, right? I mean, what else am I gonna do? This looks like a typical tactic in his opening that I've fallen for. So my knight is hanging now. Three pieces attacking it, so I'm gonna lose the knight, so I'm gonna have to take this, I think. So let's just take it. Maybe after castles, I have pressure on f7 though. So now I'm only losing one pawn, and here, do I just castle? He takes the bishop then. Can I play? If I castle, he takes the bishop. Maybe I can play knight to, I don't know. It's not great that he's gonna take that bishop. Really not good. Well, this is gonna be a quick recording, I think. A3 might work. Now I have to take with the c pawn. It's ugly. A3, queen a5. No, that loses the bishop, the knight. A3, only move, queen to b6, right? And then maybe night to d5. Queen to a5 check. Queen to a5 check. Cannot play c3. Can play bishop to d2. And he has to play maybe queen back. Queen back to d8. I think I should try that. Otherwise, I'm just like if I just castle and he takes my bishop and I take back, it just looks pretty ugly. So a3. Let's just try it. Let's try it. And I could also play problem is this bishop is unprotected. So he maybe gets something like knight takes on c2 check. Oh well, now if I move my knight next to d5, the bishop is protected. So the queen b6, knight to d5, queen to a5 check, bishop back, and just try and save my bishop there somehow. And my knight on d5 is kind of active. I thought those simplifications would really hurt me because I'm losing right now, so fell into his opening favorite opening. Okay, did not foresee that move. He takes the bishop. I have to take his queen. He takes my queen. And those double pawns are probably good for me, but I have double pawns myself. But so if I castle right now, I'm saying if I castle right now, do I have to save my bishop? Do I have to play bishop to a2? What can I castle? Castle, he takes, I take. Oh, I take the queen, he doubles his pawns, I take back then. And then his bishop on g7 looks pretty menacing. And he can go to e2, I suppose. But then my bishop's gone, isn't it? Why do I put my bishop on d5 now? And he plays. He'll play e6 then. But I'm causing trouble, right? I mean, he can just run away with a knight, possibly. I want to keep that bishop. So, bishop to d5. He no longer has queen to a5 check. So, bishop to d5, e6. Maybe I can even play like. Can I play knight to b5? Knight to b5, double attack. Well, that doesn't work until that doesn't work. That would only work if it's no, that would not work at all. Because then I would defend the queen. But bishop to d5. It's kind of a tempo move. E6 weakens the dark squares a lot. I can't even consider just going for that because I'm attacking the rook at the end of the line. Yeah, I might just go for this and not waste too much more time. Can probably just move the knight away somehow. Well, actually, he has nowhere to go. He could move the knight back, knight to e6, but it looks awkward. So at least maybe this game is good calculation practice. I'm actually trying to see some good lines to rescue this game and play actively since I'm a pawn down. If I was playing the Benko, I'd be a pawn down anyway, right? So still be fine. It's a psychological thing, isn't it? It's okay. E6, what do I do? Okay, he's gonna choose to keep that like that. Some castles now. I also have maybe knight to b5. At which point he has to go queen to b8. Is that right? Can I trap the queen somehow? Mean, knight to b5. Queen to e5, let's say. It's possible. Very much possible. Castles. He also just castles, right? Knight to b5. Queen there. It looks pretty bad. Well, maybe I can play g3 and then bishop there. I know my b2 pawn is hanging, but I can maybe win this exchange. That rook. Somehow. Thing is, if I just castle and he castles, doesn't look great. I'm gonna try that, I think. Why not? What's the worst that can happen? E6, I can play my bishop back maybe to c4. C3 for bishop to d4. Bishop to d4 is not great. Well, although c3, if he castles. Well, I mean, I will win the bishop, nothing more. Well, what about now, though? Bishop takes, and then bishop to d4. Bishop takes knight. Pawn takes. My knight is hanging. Bishop here. Queen has to move away. Win the bishop with tempo. That's probably good. Half 15 minutes, let's double check. Take the knight, he has to take back. Bishop to d4. He has queen check. No. an unfortunate check. What do I say? Work. And surely Levi Castle, though. Maybe Levi Castle will have some chances, though. Take. Queen to f3, castles. How do I just castles and he castles? I'd say the knight and I play my queen, my bishop there. I don't get anything though, because the king is protecting the bishop. Well, I mean, I guess something. Oh, I don't get a. No, because knight c7 check is not going to happen anymore. What's sacrifice? Sacrifice and castles with check. Doesn't seem like it brings to anything. Sacrifice on f7 takes castles with check. Can we just put the bishop out there? I almost went for the bishop takes knight and I would have failed to check, so it's good I double checked. Bishop takes knight. Castle c castles, maybe I can play bishop to f. But no, that doesn't. Maybe that wins me the exchange still. So I'm gonna have to try that. Didn't see anything better. Maybe that gives him a chance to blunder. Maybe he plays a6 or something. He doesn't need to, I think he should just castle. Oh, actually he can because he has to defend f7, so he will castle. He will castle. Yeah, so here I was thinking bishop to f4. Trying to win the rook. Bishop to d4 doesn't work anymore, does it? Just completely fails, actually, no? Maybe I'll try this then. Come on. You can take b2. If you like. Taking knight to c7. Actually, queen takes on b2 might completely fail to rook to b1. Oh, not completely. He goes back to f6. That looks pretty dodgy for him though, because maybe I even get e5. That looks overly greedy. What else is he supposed to do? It's true. Queen to h5, g4. I think he's gonna play queen takes. Queen takes to d2. And then. Okay, so rook a2 now. Rook b1. And the queen is forced all the way back to f6. Okay, he's gonna opt for the double pawns there. But actually, I thought maybe g4. What did he see? G4. Okay, so he's saying g4. I guess queen h4. Bishop g3, queen g5. Somehow it looks like his queen will be running away, right? This is not right. I can win an exchange here though. I would lose a pawn. Feels like taking the queen has to be good for me. Take the queen, knight to c7, rook to b8. And then I can take the knight. Oh no, it's not great. Knight to c7 first. Don't have too much time. Come on, what else have I got? G4, can't take. He has to move. H4, H3. H3, rook to f3, h4. So h4, bishop to g3, h3. Think I should try that. Looks messy though. G4, queen h4, bishop with queen back, maybe h4. And he has queen to e3 check, which I'm not happy about. Don't really have too much more time. Take. Knight there. Rook moves. Take the knight. Takes back. Advance the pawn? No. 7 minutes. I need to do something. Well, attack the queen, then play the knight, then put my rook, my queen on f3. Could be good. Let's just do it. 7 minutes. I have to just play something sharp and fast because I'm just losing otherwise. I guess I can't play rook to f3 if he plays on queen to h3. That's a bit unfortunate because I dropped my g-pawn. I'm gonna play knight to c7 next anyway. And maybe pull my bishop back to make room for my knight coming in there. Sounds reasonable. Did just notice a problem though. If he plays d6, this pawn is awfully weak. This pawn is it's a problem. I mean, rook here, he takes, we check. Rook there, I drop my bishop. So not ideal. I'm just gonna play this and see. Like I said, I think I need to make something happen here, so. Minutes left, so I just need to speed up and see what happens. I have been studying a lot of endgame, but it's mostly technical draws and wins, so that doesn't really help in the beginning of the endgame. Okay, so rook to b8, could play knight to a6, but 9 to 6 takes, 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 takes. I'm just losing an exchange. I'm winning an exchange there, which is probably not enough of the g4 drops. Rook outright. Try and repeat moves and escape with a draw. Maybe that's the best result I can hope for here. It might be. About e4. He gets knight to b4. a4, knight to b4. Rook to a3. Can I just always take the knight as well? Taking a knight really helps him right now though, because taking d to c6 looks very favorable for him. So I wonder if I should just repeat moves here. Knight to b5. Honestly, I don't see anything much better. I don't want to play knight a6. giving up too much material, I think. Plus, with the queens on board, not big fun. Knight back here. Let's see what he does. I'm low on time, so I'll probably take the draw if he does. Okay, let's do it one more time. Bail out with a draw here, I think. Yeah, I can repeat one more time. So let's see, is there anything else? Is there anything more than a draw in this position? Right, if I go knight b5 again, that's the last time before the draw, right? Knight to a6 doesn't look good. With his queen and his bishop that's gonna be active soon, my king looks pretty poor. Rook to f3, queen takes. Bishop back to g3, that doesn't look good. Bishop takes on f7. Doesn't look good. Bishop to g3. Bishop to g3, attacking f7 twice. Can probably bring it down for a third time. 4 minutes left. Bishop to g3, queen to f3. Just looks like he will have some sort of defense there. I mean, even just d6, right? D6, and then what? And then I'm lost. Let's just do it one more time then. Let's take the draw. He might not want the draw now. Okay, he is doing this. Is that a move? I don't take the knight now. If he takes the bishop, I have to take with the rook. If I take. This is probably a good move. Yeah, so I'm not gonna get away with a draw here, it seems. Just have to remember this pawn is hanging as well. What if I take with a knight? He takes my bishop. No, that's not good. That's always coming with checkmate threats. This is pretty bad. I got 3 minutes left. Knight take. He takes with the bishop. Saying he's gonna checkmate me. Take with a rook. He takes a knight. And I've completely lost. Mm-hmm. queen here. Attacking his queen, forcing some trades. Might be able to survive that, so let's try that. Don't know what else to do, what to do, so. So I'm just gonna do that and see what happens. Minutes left, so I just need to stir things up. Although trading queens, he's a pawn up. He's probably just winning. He's a piece up, right? So if I take this, can he attack? He gets some sort of desperado move. Can I actually take first? Maybe I get to double somehow. I take the knight first, that just doesn't look good, so I'm gonna just take here first. Least his bishop might be bad. 1 minute 42 seconds. Okay, no more talking, just move, because no increment. Okay, so I was thinking here maybe I can get away with sacrificing, but he just plays there. What takes and then take with the rook. He always has knight back to defend. Let's just go here. The bishop. He doesn't take with the bishop, that'd be great, but he will. So let's get back. Shattered. Did not see that coming. It's game over now. My bishop's trapped as well. Terrible. E6. Actually, yeah, there's no way for me to get out of that either, so. Maybe something crazy. Everything is winning for black, so I have 46 seconds left, so I'm just trying crazy, weird stuff. Just step out of the pin. Resign. It's pretty obvious that I've lost. Alright, well, I only know like two lines against the accelerated dragon, so maybe that's a wake-up call. I should study some opening theory, because yeah, I think it was downhill from the opening, which doesn't usually happen to me, so that's a shame. See you next time.